हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय यूट्यूब चैनल स्टेनो फाइटर। अगर आप चाहते हैं कि मेरी वीडियोस आपके पास सबसे पहले पहुंचे, तो मेरे चैनल स्टेनो फाइटर को अभी सब्सक्राइब करें और बेल के आइकन को दबाना ना भूलें, क्योंकि यह बिल्कुल फ्री है। तो दोस्तों, अब मैं डिक्टेशन प्रोवाइड कर रहा हूँ 130 वर्ड पर मिनट की स्पीड से, कैलाश चंद्रा, ट्रांसक्रिप्शन नंबर 134। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। 10 seconds, 5 seconds, start. In view of the recommendations made by the Backward Classes Commission, the Government of India examined the matter in consultation with the state governments concerned. This is exactly what we have decided and what has been incorporated in the present bill. As a result, it has been decided that in the case of Rajasthan, the area restriction should be removed altogether, because in Rajasthan, this population has been spread over a very large area. It was found that they were entitled to this measure of protection, and therefore this area restriction has not been kept up in respect of Rajasthan at all. In the case of the other two states, namely Maharashtra and Madhya Pradesh, the tribes residing in tehsils where there is concentration of 20% or more of tribal population should be specified as scheduled tribes. This is point number 2 so far as the salient recommendations of the Backward Classes Commission were concerned. Then, sir, the third point was regarding the actual omissions or actual additions. There were a number of communities. In respect of this, there are certain difficulties also which I shall be pointing out very soon. So far as the Backward Classes Commission's recommendations in this respect were concerned, there were certain natural handicaps. When we received their recommendations regarding either additions or omissions, naturally we had to depend upon the well-considered views of the state governments. As I stated to the House, there was a double reference. The first reference was at the preliminary stage, and the second reference was with regard to the tentative proposals that the government and had evolved. Therefore, in this case, after the receipt of the views of the state governments, the Government of India finally recast what they had prepared in the light of these views. Generally, what has been done is when there has been a recommendation which is supported both by the Backward Classes Commission and the state government, then we accept that particular community either for addition if formerly it was not there, or for omission if omission has been jointly supported by both these people. If, for example, there is a difference of opinion between them, then the government considered the matter. I would point out that the state governments have a number of means of knowing the correct position so far as these are concerned. So far as the Backward Classes Commission was concerned, there were certain handicaps as pointed out to you, and therefore we have tried to follow the views of the state governments to the extent that it is necessary. In a few cases, naturally, we had to come to certain conclusions irrespective of the view either of the Backward Classes Commission or of the state governments. But such cases are not many. And then, after considering all these things, we have prepared the list, and you will find in the scheduled attached to the bill the names of the various committees which ought to be recognized so far as either the scheduled castes or scheduled tribes are concerned. One more important question arises so far as the number of these communities is concerned. That was a very difficult task. Now, what happened in 2011 was naturally representations were made to the government that we ought to give up encouraging or perpetuating caste system. And therefore, when the 2011 census had to be prepared, the question arose as to whether government should have the enumeration through their officers in respect of the members of the separate castes as well, or whether the enumeration should be confined to the groups or categories of scheduled castes as a whole and scheduled tribes as a whole. For example, take a particular community, the Bhil community. In some of the former census, we had these communities shown separately, but in the 2011 census, on account of the decision that the government took, there was this view that we should not go on perpetuating the various castes and tribes. The desire was to amalgamate all of them under these two recognized heads, namely the scheduled castes and the scheduled tribes. Therefore, a separate enumeration as Bhil was not generally mentioned. I am mentioning only one community, not the others. What was done was when the man stated that he belonged to a particular tribe or a caste, then the enumerator found out whether he was one of the scheduled castes or scheduled tribes recognized by the president's order. Then his name was shown in the category of scheduled castes or scheduled tribes without mentioning the special community. Afterwards, this commission was appointed. One of them, results of the appointment of this commission was naturally the accentuation of the emphasis on castes and tribes. Every community began to plead because after all certain rights were given. This political right of representation was also given, and therefore every community thought it advisable to claim that either they were a scheduled caste or a scheduled tribe.